All right, John Oakes here with Hankster's Hot Rods here in our Homer City, PA location. And today we're going to go over our newest addition to our inventory, and that is this 1989 Ford Bronco XLT four-wheel drive sitting here beside me. So as you can see, our Ford Bronco here today, this is done in the all-black exterior. This thing's pretty much practically all factory stock original stuff here. So no modifications to the body, obviously. We've got bright work, including the bumpers, the grille, the headlight bezels. Of course, we've got all your wheel lip moldings there, your Bronco XLT badges on the front fender. You've got this side body molding here all the way down the side of the vehicle here. And again, your rear wheel lip moldings there too. Now again, all black on the outside, including the top for this. The top's in great shape. Tinted windows here in the side of it. All of the glass, the windshield, the side glass, and the glass in the top here, in the rear top cover, all of this is in great condition. There's no chips, there's no cracks, even scratches, very, very, very few and far in between. Now, as far as your doors, you can see your gaps there on the front side of the door as well as the back side, all of which very uniform. Elevations are very good, and body lines all line up on this vehicle. As far as the wheels and tires, these would be like your factory stock original wagon spoke style wheels here. They've got the beauty rings in them. Of course, this is a four-wheel drive vehicle, so you do have the manual locking hubs. Wheels are 15 by 8s, and as far as the tires go, I believe these are 255/70 R15s on all four corners. Again, no lift on this vehicle. This is pretty much stock height for it. We're going to open this up and we'll take a look on the inside. Again, this would be just your factory interior, so your carpeting, your seat upholstery, headliner, dash, everything that you see here, door panels too. This would be all factory stock stuff. You do have power windows, power door locks, factory gauges, which all work. You've got the factory steering wheel there with the cruise control buttons in the steering wheel. It is a column shift automatic. And again, like I said, for the four-wheel drive, you do have the manual locking hubs. All of your weather stripping and seal through the doors here, all of that is in good shape. Again, these are the captain style buckets up front. You do have a full bench in the rear for your seating. So that's the interior. We'll continue on to the back again. Nice super straight body panels on this vehicle. We'll come around to the back side now, where again, you're gonna see the tailgate here. Again, all factory stock. All of your trim and your cladding here is all factory. Your taillight lenses, those are all in great shape. No chips or cracks in there. You'll notice we do have the spare tire mount with the full-size spare and the Ford Bronco cover, which this is all new. Of course, your rear window here, it's tinted also. This is a power window, and we'll go ahead and we'll take a look at this. We'll open this up, but to do so, it's all power, so we're gonna go ahead and power the window down and then open our tailgate up. Okay, so then we'll reach in. There we go. So you just want to make sure that you've got your window all the way down, and we'll lower that down. Now, as you can see, your rear tailgate, it is on tethers here, so it's not going to drop down any further than what those allow it to. You can see the rear is all carpeted. Again, that bench seat in the back, it is removable. So if you ever need the extra room to haul anything, you can take that out. You've got more than ample room in there to do so. All of your panels inside are still in very good shape for a 1989. As you can see, the top of the rear here is all in good condition, all black underneath. And you've got a set of floor mats in here too that you can utilize. So we'll go ahead and raise this back up again. It latches nice. We'll go ahead and swing our spare tire back around. And then I'll just go ahead and close the window up later. Okay, and that all latches in. Not gonna go anywhere. So we'll come around again. Your metal on your spare tire mount is all in great shape. Those hinges in great shape. A lot of times you'll get these where they flake paint off and you'll get kind of that surface rust on here, but this thing's in great shape. Again, as we come down the passenger side of the vehicle, you'll see all the condition of the glass here. You've got these grab bars right here, or Landau bars here, whatever you want to call them. They are there for your assistance to get in and out of the vehicle. Again, you can see all the bright work. You can see your gaps here on the passenger side. And again, I didn't mention, but you do have the mirrors here, both driver and passenger side. All of your glass is in excellent shape. All of your trim, your moldings, everything around all of your windows, again, all in great shape. We'll open the door up from the passenger side, take a quick peek inside. And again, for factory interior, you're going to just notice that don't have any real rips or tears in any of the upholstery. It's all in really good shape for being cloth. Again, all of your carpeting, your dash, all of that stuff is all in great condition. So we'll close this up and we'll work our way around to the front of the vehicle. And again, just the matching emblems, so forth up here. And then we come around now to the front. So again, as I said, these are just your stock headlights here. All of your lenses are in great shape. The bright work around there, the bezels, those are in great shape. Your grille, same thing. 4x4 emblems up front here too. Chrome front bumper. Of course, it's got the black molding around it too. Now we're going to go ahead and open up our hood. Let me reach in there and pop our hood. Alright, so there is a pull latch inside for the hood, and your secondary latch is right there in the grill. There is no hold up for the hood. As you can see, the hinges do that for you. Now, as far as this motor goes, as far as the whole entire driveline goes on the vehicle, this is all original driveline. So this is a 302 motor. It's a fuel injected motor. It's what this vehicle was born with. As far as the transmission, automatic transmission, as we had mentioned before, it is four-wheel drive. So you've got both Dana 44 front and rear differentials in this, all connected with a Borg Warner transfer case. And of course, the rear gear in this thing is a 355, so it'll be a good highway vehicle for you too. Now, as you can see, everything in here is pretty much all stock. You've got the electronic fuel injection, no carburetor, obviously. You've got the EFI aluminum intake there. You've got dual exhaust, obviously dual cast manifolds on it that empty in two into one, and then a single muffler with all your catalytic converters still intact, and we'll show you that once we get underneath the vehicle. Of course, all of your air inlet hoses are all in great shape. Radiator hoses, all of your belts, those are all in great condition too. Now, this is a power steering and power brake vehicle. You do have discs up front, drums in the rear with it. Of course, with the fuel injection, it's an electric fuel pump too. All of your stock ignition and so forth is still retained in this vehicle as well. So that's pretty much it for a Bronco, at least around the outside, interior, and under the hood. So we'll go ahead next, we'll get this on the lift for you, go through the complete underside, which again is in great condition, and then finally we'll open the hood back up for you and we'll fire this motor up. That way you get to hear how nice and smooth this thing sounds for being a 302 fuel injected motor. All right, so we're underneath our 89 Ford Bronco XLT. So as always, we're gonna go through the underside of this with you, starting from front, work our way to the back, going over all the things such as the steering, the suspension, brakes, the driveline, frame, and floors on this thing. So again, 89 Ford Bronco, you're gonna have all your typical front suspension here. This is all stock stuff here that we're looking at right now. Now you do have the dual shock setup on this particular one. It's got dual Gabriel Ultra shocks up front. Now as far as your suspension goes, other than that, you do have a front sway bar with this. You also have a rear sway bar. So again, for a Bronco being up a little higher like this, that's going to help this thing as far as when it comes to cornering and so forth. Now, as far as your differentials underneath here, these are both, your front and rears are both Dana 44 differentials, which makes it real nice because all your components are going to be the same. You do have power brakes and power steering on this vehicle as well. Disc brake up front, drums out on the back of the vehicle. Now, as far as this goes, when we come back from our differentials here, they're going to come into the Borg Warner transfer case that we have. And then, of course, now you're going to have your rear drive shaft in coming back to your rear Dana 44 here. Now, the gear that's in here, this is a 355 gear ratio. And again, suspension. All your typical stock stuff here. You got your leaf springs, multi-leafs. Got your rear shocks, just typical gas shocks. Of course, again, that sway bar that I just mentioned not too awfully long ago. So that's your front and rear suspension. Again, power steering, power brakes. As far as the driveline on this car goes, this is all original driveline. So you've got a 302 electronic fuel injected motor here. We've got that backed up with a automatic transmission. And then, like I said, that Dana 44 out back with the 355 gear. The frame and floors on this thing are in excellent condition. There's no patching whatsoever, no holes, nothing, no replacement panels. This thing is in great condition underneath here. The frame, nice and straight, the floors, you can see all of the stamping lines and everything, and all of the braces are still all here underneath. Even as you come back underneath the bed here, you've got all your braces and your floor clear back here, even up over top of your fuel tank. Your fuel tank's in excellent shape too on this thing. There's not a mark on it. You've got the cover that goes around it. All your mounting hardware is in great shape too. Now, as far as your exhaust system, you can see it's got pretty much what this thing would have come with stock. You've got your exhaust coming down off your stock cast exhaust manifolds, two into one. You've got your catalytic converters. You've got a small one right here. You've also got a slightly larger one back here. Then you've got a single Flowmaster muffler, and then of course your single tailpipe that exits out right underneath your passenger side rear quarter panel. Now, as far as wheels and tires, 15 by 8 wheels on all four corners here. And as far as the tire size, 255/70 R15s on this vehicle. Tread's in excellent shape. The tires look new. So again, nothing like that is going to, you know, throw you off. It's going to handle great. It's going to grip the road great with the tires that's on it. And again, this frame and the floors underneath here is in excellent condition for an 89 Ford Bronco. So that's pretty much it for underneath here. We're going to lower it down now. We're going to open the hood up. We'll start that 302 fuel injected motor up, let you hear what it sounds like.